What's good, YouTube? And here we have my second to last video that I'm gonna do for this channel for a while. And this one is pretty much how you cop kicks. And the reason I got these particular kicks out at the moment, because these are all kicks that I've got within the last month, off eBay or off Craigslist. All these shoes are 100% legit. I don't fuck with fakes. And all these shoes cost me either $250 or less. And that's pretty much my goal point, to cop, let's just say, hype shoes for $250 less. But all these shoes, for the most part, are shoes that were just so hyped up and people were trying to charge $400, $500 for and shit like that. Just crazy prices. And I got all these shoes, with the exception of the Pearl Pros that I got, those I got for $300. And for those shoes, those are ones that's worth it. Those are fucking 10 years old, so they deserve to have a price like that. The rest of these do not. But let's get back to the point. All these shoes are my size. And J's, all my J's, or other Nikes like XBs and things like that, I wear a 10.5. And foam positives, I wear a size 11. I know there's some people out there that say that you should get foam positives true to your size, but I had some 10.5 cough drop foam positives, and those shits hurt like a motherfucker. Like, I tried my best to give it time for it to mold to my feet. I wore it to a gym like 3 times. I couldn't take it. I couldn't take wearing those. Couldn't wear those anymore, and every foam positive I got since then has been a size 11. Like, 11 works best for me. So if you're asking me my opinion, if you're getting foam posits, go a half a size up. That's my opinion. So what we have here, these, the first shoe I'm going to show you, these aren't really a hype shoe like that, and people weren't really feeling these. I for one do feel them. I like them a lot. But these are shoes I seen when they came out. People went into the store, bought them all up, and then threw them up on Craigslist for $250. And they retail for $160. I paid $160. So that means I paid less than retail because I didn't have to pay tax or anything. So let's get into these. And they were DS, of course. They're brand new shoe. And I'm going to show you how I do it, so don't think that I'm just going to show you these shoes and tell you how much I paid for them. That's it. I'm going to actually go and show you, like, especially on eBay, how to shop on eBay. So these are the step 10s. DS. And I actually, you know, I love it because with this shoe in particular, it's one of the prime examples of how the game is changing. Now, you can say, oh, the reason why people didn't, you know, pay those high prices for these because people wasn't feeling them. That could be. But I got another shoe. I got another shoe or two that I can show you that I know people are feeling. And I pay a lot less than what, you know, I seen them go for and I see other people paying for them. These are step 10s. DS. I like them. And all these shoes I got, all these are for the gym, really. I don't, you know, that whole rocker stock shit, that's a dumbass question for a sneakerhead in my beliefs, because I feel like when you get shoes, of course you should rock them, and the only question should be is how hard you're gonna rock them shits. You know what I'm saying? Like, rock a stock, like, what the fuck kind of question is that? Like, what is that? You know what I'm saying? So, all these shoes get wear. They all gonna get worn. I think there's one pair in here that's DS, and I plan on wearing them this summer. So, don't trip. Ain't none of these shoes gonna stay DS. I'm not stocking shit. The step 10s, 160, flat, off Craigslist. And I'm going to show you all the shoes I got off Craigslist first, because those are where I get the real deals at, Craigslist. So I pay retail with no tax. Can't beat that. DS shoe. The second shoe I want to show you, got these off Craigslist too. Now this is one of those hype shoes where people we're fucking going crazy over, and to this day I still see on Craigslist, eBay, people trying to sell these for $300, $400, DS. I got these DS. Y'all ain't gonna believe the price I paid for these, and I'm telling you, everything I'm telling you right now, I'm not gonna sit on camera and tell y'all I paid less for a shoe when I paid more, or tell y'all I paid more for a shoe when I paid less. Like, there's no glamour in that, there's no point in doing that. It doesn't, like, help me, that don't make me look good, that don't make me look bad either way, you know what I'm saying? So there's no point in lying about it. These shoes, $100. DS. And the kid I bought them from, well, he's not even a kid, he was 22. He looked like a kid. He looked like he was 17, but the kid said he was 22. And he was telling me that he pretty much getting out the game. And I noticed that a lot about a lot of sneakerheads that selling their shoes. they've been saying they're getting out the game, and I really believe this because the way the game's been. Let me show you the shoes. They were DS when I bought them. They are no longer DS. So these aren't one of those pairs that I got and didn't wear. But you can see, you know, they're pretty much DS, like on the inside and shit. And they still got the Jumpman and all that shit. I'm not, I feel like focusing it, but trust me, this is it. The Cement 3. The shoes are in immaculate condition. $100. I'm telling y'all, it's a come up. But yeah, the dude was telling me he was getting out the game because he just not feeling it no more. I don't know what his real reason was. He just said he sold all his shoes. This is like one of the last pair he had. I think other than these, he said he had the SB Space Jams. But he looking to get $350 for those, and I'm not even a fan of those anyway. I'm not spending that kind of money on no fucking SB low tops or any kind of shoe that ain't OG. So $100 for these. Craigslist. Right hand to God. Let's move on to the next shoe. Oh yeah, my girl, she swears these are the exact same shoes as the Cement 3s. I try to tell her these are nothing like, but she swears up and down there's no difference, and that I'm pretty much buying the same shoes. But as y'all can see, she has no idea what she's talking about. These are the Team Jordans 2.5. Got these years ago. I wish these were the same as the Cement 3s, because maybe they'll be the 2001. Yeah, I throw that out there. Now, this next shoe is not a hype shoe, but it was a shoe that when it came out, people bought them all up and threw them on Craigslist for $200+. Now, of course, they didn't sell like that. I don't know, maybe some idiots who copped it for that. I got these for DS. These, I got $100 too. It's crazy how I got the Black Cements for $100 and I got these for $100. So I would never thought I would have got the Black Cements for that price, especially with what I see them go for all the time. These, $100. Got these, DS. These have been worn too though. I go to the gym damn near every day, sometimes twice a day. So I wear different shoes. Even if I go twice a day, I'm not wearing the same shoes I wore in the morning that I'm going to wear when I go in the afternoon. Steph 3s. Got them DS, $100. So I'm saying, like, my point is to show you can get these shoes for good prices. And I'm a living testament, you don't have to pay that. And I don't do that for any shoe. All right, the next shoe that I got off Craigslist. I showed you this one before and I told you the price I got them for before. And that's the Eggplant Bone Posit ones. Got these for $150. Y'all seen these before? I got the soles to them. I did a video on them. I actually showed you how to see glow on them, and I showed you how to dye your soles on these. $150. You see what I'm saying? You see the pattern here? Y'all know y'all see those shoes go for fucking $400, but they're going for $400, $500. Like crazy prices for those damn shoes. Now the rest of these I got off of eBay. And once again, $250 or less. And I'm going to say it's one shoe that I paid $250 for, but I end up getting money back after I got them. And they were DS. That's a long story. I'll see if I can get to it. Actually, this right here is taking too long. I'm already 12 minutes. It may not be 12 minutes when you guys see it because I'm going to edit it down. Hopefully, I can skip out shit that I need to be on here. But I still got a lot of shit to show you. So, all these I got off eBay. All the ones I showed you before were from Craigslist. Now these, the first one I want to show you. The Electric Blues. Now, I said... Y'all know about these. Y'all know how much these have been going for. Especially when they first came out, everybody wanted to treat them like they were South Beach foams to follow after the South Beach LeBrons. These are going for $500, $600. I got these DS. Only paid $200 for them. Real shit, $200. DS. And I've worn those quite a bit to the gym. I've worn all these shoes for the most part. Next shoe I want to show you. These have yet to been rocked. These I'm waiting for the summer to pull out. DS Dark Pine Foam Pros. Now these are the ones I paid $250 for DS, but I ended up getting money back after I got them. And it was partially of me overreacting. Cause I don't know, it's a long story behind those, but I ended up getting those at the end of the day. I only paid like, I don't even want to get into that because it was like damn near free pretty much how I got those. So, but initially I paid $250 for them. And y'all seen those, you can go on eBay right now and see those same shoes people trying to sell for $400, $500. Next shoe I want to show you. The Electric Greens. These shoes I paid $185 DS. eBay, but there's a way I got the guy wanted like $220, but I ended up working a deal with them and I ended up paying $195, something like that. $185, $195 DS Electric Greens. The last shoe I want to show you, actually this should have been in the Craigslist pile. I got them on Craigslist. 2007 Royal. Fucking, these are grills right here. 2007. The quality on these are amazing too. I paid $175 for these. I had to drive quite a bit though to get them, but $175. Same shoe I see go for $600, or people at least ask for $600. At the very least, these go for $300. Like, that's what people pay to get them. And that's it. That's what I wanted to show you ahead of time. The shoes that I got, just to show you that I'm not just talking out my ass. These are shoes that I got in my collection off eBay and Craigslist for way under the prices that, you know, people are trying to get for them. So with that being said, let's hop over to the computer.
So now I'm going to the computer. I want to show you exactly how to shop on eBay. Craigslist is pretty much self-explanatory. You go to your state, to your closest city, and then you want to go to clothes and accessory. Then you type in phone posit or Jordan. Then you go through all the listings. You find your sizes. You find something that's your size that you want. You hit the guy up and you go from there. That's the best way possible if it's safe in your area to do so. If it's not safe in your area, then you don't want to go that way. If you go that way and it's not safe in your area, then you fuck around and get robbed or killed or something. So I'm only suggesting Craigslist as an option if it's safe in your area to do so. And to me, like I said, it's the best way to go, because with Craigslist, you actually get to see what you're buying before you buy it. With eBay, you actually got to buy and wait to get it to see what you got. But I'm going to show you how to buy on eBay and not get ripped off. Like I showed you, that whole section off of eBay I bought, all of them was real, all of them were authentic, all of them I got for good prices. So let's get into it. So let's go to eBay. And this is usually how I do it. What I usually do is, I have a shoe in mind I'm looking for, and I keep doing phone posits because I get a lot of people asking me, can they buy phone posits? So let's just type in phone posit. And what I do is I go size 11 because that's what I wear in phone posit. And then it'll bring up all the phone posits in my size. Let's bring this to 200. There we go. So what I do is, after doing that, you pretty much gotta go through them. Right here we have a pair of pewters. I already seen these, so I'm not gonna click on every one because it'll take too long. These are a decent pair. I'm already watching them. They're at $195 right now. Actually, just click on them and see what's the how much time is left on. You got 2 hours and 3 minutes. You can buy it now for $260, or you can wait to see what it goes for. I'm pretty sure for $260, that means he's probably gonna go for under $250. Meaning, as you know, if you came to me because of you always make it going against that one guy, he had a pair of these, he was trying to sell for $450. See what I'm saying? Right here, good sell, good price. Good pair of shoes. I checked them out and everything. They're good. Now, what I want to tell you as far as buying, what you want to do. If you go through the pictures, you like what you see and everything, you're going to want to, for me, for the most part, if I see pictures that I'm comfortable with and everything, fine. You know what I'm saying? I'm good with that. Like, the feedback is a good thing to check just to see how that seller gets down. You know what I'm saying? Because feedback, you go to feedback and you'll see that this fucker doesn't, you know what I'm saying, ship fast, or he does bullshit. You may not want to deal with that. So if you check feedback for it. But for the most part, when it comes to copying kicks on eBay, you're pretty much safe. The only thing you have to worry about for the most part is sometimes sellers do not like to relinquish all the details about the shoe. Like, they're only going to show the good side. Like, they'll show all these pictures, but they will somehow miss to show the flaw. So that's like the main problem that you will have sometimes with buying used kicks off eBay, even new kicks. Because new kits come factory fucked up sometimes. And they may fail to mention that. And they mind is brand new as DS. And they feel like, you know what I'm saying, you can go to Foot Locker and buy them. And they can have this kind of flaw and whatever. And you get it and you be like, man, this is fucked up. He didn't tell me about this. But you know what I'm saying, you could have went to a store and bought them and had that same flaw. But what I do suggest, if you see an item that you want to buy, you're interested in, hit that seller up. If you got pictures that you're not comfortable with, tell him to send you more pictures. And tell him to tag the picture. And tagging pictures basically is write his eBay name on a sheet of paper and write the date on a sheet of paper. That's tagging it. That way you know that the pictures actually belong to him. And that also you know that those pictures are current because it has the today's date on that. So that's how you kind of get that, you know, this guy ain't just stealing pictures from other sellers or off the internet trying to sell it and get money. But even for the most part, if you do that, you pay him. Like the guy, I've sold on eBay before. I sold iPhones before. And what happens is you don't, as a seller, unless you're a long time seller who's been doing it for a long time, you don't actually get the money until the buyer actually receives their item and leaves you a feedback. So for the most part, I don't know why anybody would waste their time putting up fake listings on eBay, because they're not going to get the money. So don't worry about, oh, I pay somebody, they don't really have the shoes. I mean, it's a waste of time. That's frustrating itself. But at the end of the day, you're not gonna lose your money. But like I said, make sure you do those things. Make sure you get tag pictures if you're not comfortable with the pictures you see. If the seller hasn't sold enough shoes or have enough feedback where you can just like don't even care if he has tag pictures or not. Like 14, that's not a lot. So if you click on it, let's see what his feedback is. So he don't even have any feedbacks as far as selling. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, for the most part, you can not go for him because he doesn't have a really seller feedback or whatever, or a seller background. But for the most part, you know what I'm saying? Check his pictures. If you're unhappy with the pictures, have him send you some more tag. For the most part, a seller's gonna send you pictures. If they don't, then don't fuck with them. If they can't send you some pictures that you're asking for, then you don't want to fuck with that person anyway. But for the most part, you're gonna get the pictures and make sure you ask them to tag it. And after you see that and they're all tagged, You make your decisions from there. So let's go back. That was Pewters. You know what I'm saying? Dirt cheap, right? $450. Great price. We have some pearls right here. $125. Buy it now. Oh my God, that's a steal. But they may be ragged out. Let's check them out. They don't look ragged out at all. Saving my lightly used foam posit pearl, 11 big for me. Too big for my hate fakes and whatever wearing. And these are not fake. I'll show you a fake. These aren't fake. I know fakes from a mile away. These are legit. Like I said, this guy only has one feedback. Have this guy send you some tag pictures if you're not comfortable. But you gotta be aware of this. This is $125. For the most part, somebody may be end up buying this any second now. That's a good price for these pictures. But you can buy it, hit buy it now, and have the guy send you some pictures before you actually pay for it. And if he refuses to send you pictures, then you cancel your order with him. But I'm saying, if he legit, he's going to send you pictures anyway. Don't even trip about that. This right here, great price. $125, you can't beat that. Free shipping. Like I'm skeptical. I'm trying to find out what the fuck the problem is. But he's saying it's too big for him. But like I said, at the end of the day, you can't really lose. You know what I'm saying? Like, only thing you can really lose is time. And in this situation, all you can really lose is time. In other situations where you do really receive a shoe, but it's not in the condition that you thought they would be in, what you lose then pretty much is the shipping, because you have to pay the shipping back and you don't get reimbursed for that. Sometimes you don't, sometimes you do. But for the most part, you won't. So you would lose like $12 or something shipping them back. But other than that, you don't lose anything. You lose time. Time is a important thing, and it become annoying when you start losing a lot of time trying to cop a pair of kicks. But you won't get ripped off as a buyer on eBay. As a seller, that's another situation. So they're going another good price. Electric Blues, $222. There's 3 hours left on there. I'm pretty sure that won't go over $250. If it does, not by much. But we seen somebody try to sell those for $375, right? These right here look kind of ragged out. I myself do not like ragged out shoes. I don't like them at all. I like my shit to be very near DS, but I prefer DS. For the most part, these look clean as fuck. $190. Damn, it's 29 days. Oh, $190 buy it now. See, look at this. Like, if I was trying to cop some shoes right now, I will purchase these. Like I said, those look, let me see what he says. He wore them a couple of times. At that bottom, that looks pretty much brand new. All these pictures are taken at the same time, you can tell. But like I said, if you're uncomfortable, have this person send you some pictures, tag pictures, and you'll be straight with that. and for the most part, you're protected. He has a lot of feedback, so I'm not even tripping. It's 100%. I would go for these. If I was interested in buying these pearls, I would go for those. And you can make an offer. He'll probably take shit 175, you know what I'm saying, 170. But like I said earlier, I see the game changing already. The prices are already coming down. Like, I think people are just getting fed up and people aren't really selling them like that. But you still got those assholes out there really trying to get over. Like right now, those playoff 12s came out today. People are trying to sell them for 300, 325, and they only worth 160. And then, I mean, that's the nature of the beast. These electric limes, I seen those go for 240, brand new, when they first came out. Nobody really fucking with those. Those are ugly ass shoes. I seen them in person, like fucking bananas. Like, those are awful shoes. But people gonna try to get that money anyway. That's just the nature of the beast, like I said. 175 for some damn near brand new electric greens. Like, these are prices that cheaper than what I pay. So, and like I said, 18 feedback, not that high. If you're interested, have the guy send you tag photos. Now, another prop you can do to get a better deal on kicks, and I've done it before, is you can hit the seller up in the message, tell them, look, you know what I'm saying, to save you some money and save myself some money, I'll pay you directly through PayPal. But here's the thing with that. If you do that, have them send you an invoice first. Don't just have them give you their PayPal email address and you send them the money. No. Have them send you an invoice and then you pay, because then that's just like a regular transaction off eBay. And never send a payment to any seller as a fucking gift. That's automatically, you can get ripped off and you can't do shit about it. You may be lucky and get your money back, but 9 times out of 10, you ain't getting shit back. So never send a seller a payment as a gift. Always have them send you an invoice and have them say exactly what it's for and how much and everything. You pay that and you're good that way. PayPal respects an invoice like it's any other transaction. Like if it's off eBay, if it's off any other kind of website, if it's off fucking FootLocker.com itself, you know what I'm saying? You pay through PayPal. If FootLocker.com accepts PayPal, I don't know if it's saying as an example. You got, you know, a legitimate, you know, if something goes wrong, you got a legitimate claim and you'll get your money back. So, good with this. These prices right now are fucking great. All the people who ask me where you can get phone posits for cheap, I'm showing you right now. And Craigslist is even better. Like I said, you can go in person, if it's safe, go in person. Meet in public areas, Starbucks, grocery stores, Walmart, shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Don't go to nobody's house and shit like that. And you get to see up front what you buying. You know what I'm saying? Ain't gonna be no surprises when you buying up front. So that's the best way. And usually you get the best price because on Craigslist, people don't have to pay eBay fees. They don't have to pay PayPal fees. So, you know what I'm saying? You say they saving money and you save money. So as you can see, people are still trying to get a lot of these, but like I said, these are $260 right here. I wouldn't even pay $260. That's a good price because they retail for $220 with tax, like $230 something. So you're not really paying that much. Basically, you're just paying retail and shipping, and you know what I'm saying. That's what you could look at it. But those shoes are fucking ugly. Fakes. These are fakes. You know what I'm saying? Fakes all fucking day. And if you get ripped off buying some fakes, your ass just don't know fucking kicks, and you're a fucking hype beast. You're just trying to get some shit because everybody else having, and you probably deserve it. Because any sneakerhead from a fucking mile away, you can tell these shits are fake. The carbon fibers, the stickers, the foam ain't even real foam. It's bullshit. Fake. The guy does admit they're replicas, so there you go. And look at it, 12 bigs. People still fucking want the shit, so. And they're fucking used up. But hey, $85 for some, that's gonna probably get more than that. $100 probably. And be good. Galaxies, those aren't, you're not getting those for fucking 250 people or just going crazy. But yo, that's how it is. That's the game. Buy now, $280 or best offer. These are pearls. I hate when people say they're sold out everywhere. Like, you fucking know that already. Doesn't come with the OG box. I love to have my boxes. Like I said, I would definitely have this person send me more pictures. I only got one feedback and one picture. And like I said, with this person, if you got the time, you can hit them up. Tell them I'll pay that directly through PayPal. Pay him what, I don't know, like $230 or something. Directly PayPal, he don't have to pay eBay fees, and he's good. Look at these OG metallic silvers, pros. $375 best offer. You're probably gonna end up paying like $300 for those still. But those are OG, those are classics, so those are worth it. Let's go some more pewters, $275, a lot less than $450. Like, you know what I'm saying? People are always, and this is, I want to address this. People try to say, oh, who would you rather buy it from? A guy who puts his face out on YouTube that stands behind his product, but fucking wants to charge you fucking a rate price, or a guy on eBay that you can't see. The way I look at it, a guy's feedback on eBay is his face. That's his face. You know what I'm saying? If he has good feedback, that's his face. That's what makes him trustworthy. You don't have to see his fucking actual face. And like I said, you want a website where you get protected. People could talk about, oh, I got ripped off for this amount. That's because they were selling. You know what I'm saying? You get ripped off as a seller because motherfuckers can rip you off as a seller. As a buyer, you're pretty much protected. Only thing you really stand to lose as a buyer is time and shipping prices here and there. But other than that, you're not going to lose on eBay. I've been using eBay for fucking years, since 2005, I believe. And I've never got ripped off like fuck. Like, where I paid somebody, I didn't get nothing, I didn't get my money back. That's never happened. Ever, not one time. And I'm not gonna sit here and make you a video telling you this and not know this. I've been shopping on eBay for years. I just showed you all the kicks I bought off eBay, so I know how it works. And you're good as a buyer on eBay. As far as you getting ripped off, for the most part, if you have a guy send you pictures and everything, for the most part, they're gonna send you the shoe they sent you pictures of. You may have some scammer do all this, go through all this trouble for $200 and send you some fakes. If you know they're fakes, you fucking open up a claim right away. You know what I'm saying? Send it back to his ass and you get your money back. Bottom line, you may lose in fucking shipping, but not necessarily. But you may lose in $12, but hey, $12 is, you know, a good price to pay for a lesson learned. You know what I'm saying? That's the way I look at it. So I'm not gonna keep going through this, but this is, you know, this is what it is. All day long. Prices like this all day long. I know this because I check on the daily. And that's how you find good prices. You have to be very patient. You have to stick to your morals. Go in it already in your mind, within your mind, how much you're willing to pay for a shoe. You shouldn't be paying over $250 for any phone project, unless it's a classic. When I say classic, I'm talking at least 2007 on down. You know what I'm saying? Anything other than that, you're getting ripped off if you're paying more than that. The metallic reds, the coppers. I've seen some coppers on here recently. Matter of fact, let me go. I don't have time. This video is way too long. But I've seen coppers recently go for under $200. I mean, go for under $300. I think the guy wanted like $230 or something. And they were in pretty decent condition. So with that being said, as long as you're patient, as long as you stick to your morals, you will get any kick you want for a good price. Sometimes even under retail. Like I said, I got my those stuffed tents under retail. I got the 2007 Worlds under retail.
The Musica, the hair.
And I got the eggplants under retail. So it happens. And it happens a lot. And mostly, for the most part, that happens on Craigslist. But you know what I'm saying? If it's not safe, go on eBay and be patient. Don't get caught up in the, you know, when you're bidding on something and you, while you're bidding on it, you already start imagining yourself with it. So you kind of get tunnel vision and you want that item so bad where you end up paying more than what you wanted to initially. Don't let that happen to yourself. Put in how much you're willing to pay, and if it goes over that, go on to the next fucking shoe. Keep looking. Even when you bid on something, keep looking. Keep being patient. One thing about eBay, one thing about Craigslist, a person could be uploading what you've been looking for the right price right at that second. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta keep looking. It's never you check today and you're good for the day, because, you know what I'm saying, as soon as you get done checking, by the time you get off, somebody could have just uploaded. Now, I'm not saying stay in front of the computer fucking 24 hours, but every chance you get, just keep checking. And be patient, and you'll find what you want for cheap. I promise you that. I've done it every time. I've done it. Like, I don't pay rate prices. I don't pay, not necessarily even rate prices, but just what I don't feel is a good price for it. At the end of the day, I determine what something is worth to me. And I feel like any phone pod that's not a classic, a 2007 or lower, is not worth $300. It ain't worth over $250. Bottom line. there you go. That's my advice to you on how to cop kicks for cheap. Be patient, stick to your morals, and you'll get what you want eventually. It may take a week, it may take a month, but you will get it. I mean, in my mind, is a month of waiting worth fucking saving $200? It is to me. One thing my grandma told as me being raised, a penny saved is a penny earned. So if I save $200, I earn $200. I got an extra $200 in my pocket because I was being patient. I mean, that's worth it. See you guys in the next video.